Welcome to Unfiltered.
Hey, January's rolling on, and it's let me tell you, it has been crazy busy around here at the studio this week and next week as well. Going to be crazy because we're in the school budget cycle right now. Past Saturday, we had a turned out to be just over 5 hours of actual meeting time. As the department heads presented their budgets to the school board finance committee. And while I believe the entire school board was there and able to ask questions, it was considered a finance committee meeting. There's also one this coming Saturday that will answer any questions that arose from last week's meeting. And then the following Tuesday, which will be a week from tonight, is the public hearing on the budget. That's where the public gets to ask questions, make comments. And that happens in the high school auditorium, if you're interested in that. And you would think that with a, I want to say it's $63 million. That's a huge budget. You, the taxpayer, can have input on that. So, you know, while as a guy that's going to be there filming it, I don't want it to go any longer than it really has to. I would just as soon see that auditorium be filled with people concerned about the school budget. That's my opinion. You know, you have input. All you have to do is show up. You'll have your chance to voice your opinion to the school board. And they listen. It's not like they just, you know, close their ears off when people start talking. They listen. These are a lot of smart people on our school board that we've got in Keene. And they're trying to do their best to fully educate the kids. You know, it's not just the 3 R's anymore. In a time when the biggest cost, and you can probably say this about any business, the biggest cost is benefits, having to provide benefits for all their employees. And, you know, and I think this is a more of a problem. It's pension systems and schools that have to pay into, you know, these companies that have to pay into pension systems. The problem with pension systems is, like the Social Security system, you can't work someplace for 20 years and pay into the system for 20 years and then retire and collect a pension for 50. Third grade math will tell you that. You know, it's, the problem is, and I say problem because yes, it's a problem. People are living longer. That's the problem. When this whole Social Security, pension kind of stuff came about, you started collecting at 65 and you were lucky if you made it to 70. So back then you would pay in for 20 years or 25 years and you would collect for five. Nowadays, you pay in for 20 years, you collect for 40 or 50 years. And it doesn't work. This card is like a dollar. You can't stretch it. No matter how you try, you just can't stretch it. So, you know, that's happening. Show up. Give some input. February, and I want to say I'm not solid on this, so I'll get back to you in a future episode, but I believe the first session where the public, that's you folks, can actually vote on the school budget. But you have to go out to the auditorium. That's another meeting that's held in the auditorium. It's a day-long process where they lay out the budget and they have all the votes. And you, the public, vote on the school board budget and on the school budget. If there's only three people that show up, guess what? Three people basically decided what the school budget's going to be. If 1,000 people show up, imagine that, 1,000 people show up and say, hey man, we want to be part of this. The school wouldn't know what to do. I'm not sure how much the auditorium holds, but I would love to see that place, standing room only, for the first session. You know, that's the community taking charge. School board is elected by the people to represent the people. But when it comes to budget time, the school board says, why should we just represent you when you can show up and represent yourself? These people don't have to represent you. They're giving you the opportunity to represent yourself. So show up. Show up with a statement. Short statement. You know, and don't repeat yourself. And if somebody else makes your point, don't feel like you have to go up and also make that point. Unless maybe you go up to the mic and say, yeah, I agree with that guy. Plain and simple. It's a matter of numbers. The school, and if the, when the school board figures out that, yes, we are all watching and we are all interested, it makes them feel better about all the work that they do. That's all I'm saying. Get involved. You know? I know all you lefty Dems are cringing in your seat right now. What do you mean get involved? That's a government business. Yeah, the government doesn't handle it. The more we handle ourselves, the less the government has to handle. It doesn't take a bureaucracy of 2,000 or 3,000 people in some department somewhere to give a homeless guy a burger. It doesn't take that. It takes you and me just doing our part. That's it. I don't know. Anyway, yeah, crazy week because those budget stuff is going on with the school, and as soon as the school wraps up its budget stuff, then we start kicking into city council budget process, which is the CIP budget, and then right on the heels of that is the operating budget, which I believe culminates in June or July, something like that, I think, which is the end of the fiscal year for the city. So, what else is going on? Throughout the weekend, I always hear stories and it pops into my head, man, I should rant about that on Unfiltered. By the time Tuesday gets here, which I'm actually taping on Tuesday morning this week, I can't think of anything, you know, because I woke up kind of happy this morning. Oh, I did see a, A couple of stories. One, Danny Mitchell on the morning radio show this morning, WKBK, was talking about the blue lines that we want to put in between the yellow lines on Marlboro Street to honor the police department and to show support for the police department. Apparently, and again, my hatred, and I know hatred is a strong word, but my hatred for big government boils in my system when I hear a story like this. Supposedly there is some highway rule that says that you can't paint a blue line in between the two yellow lines because, according to the government rules, the inside of those yellow lines has to look like the regular roadway. Now, I don't know if maybe you paint the whole road so that the inside of the yellow lines is the same as the outside of the yellow lines. Again, it's 10,000 government bureaucrats got together and came up with these stupid ass rules. And that's the way I think of them. You know, the federal government doesn't come down here and fix our damn potholes. The federal government doesn't pave our streets in our town. So to me, that means the people who make the decision on what happens on these streets in our town should be our town. Federal government should keep its hands out of our business. The state should keep its hands out of our business. If we feel like scrawling United States Navy across, I use Navy because I'm a sailor. You know, if we wanted to scrawl United States Navy across a street somewhere to honor the servicemen that serve, you know something? We should be able to do it. Federal government shouldn't be able to tell us, you know, how to mark our roads. I'll tell you what, the federal government, sure, let them be in charge of marking interstates. That's what they should be marking. Like stuff that covers the whole country, you know, that's not really controlled by any one place. But guess what? Our roads are controlled by us here in this town. So if we want to paint a blue line down the damn street and it gets voted on and approved by the city council, who again is representing the people, who the hell is the federal government representing with the no, you can't paint anything on the streets kind of crap? Who are they representing? When the people here think that it's cool. Again, the government says that it represents us, but it doesn't. The federal government represents itself. And the federal government is like a corporation. Granted, it's not like your normal corporation where you've got the people at the top and all the workers. The federal government is a corporation of nothing but the top. Yeah, It's a corporation of CEOs who all work together. They get their money from us, and the bigger their end of things get, the more money they can have. That's all I'm saying. You never see these people, these government bureaucrats, skipping a pay raise cycle. You don't see that. But you see guys like our fine fire department here in Keene, New Hampshire, who for a number of years didn't take raises. Yeah. That's the difference between working people and those that are up here. Working people don't mind sacrificing for the greater good. People up here, they won't sacrifice anything. Of course they won't. Because why should they only have two houses when they can have four? Yeah. Oh my God, what am I gonna talk about now? Seems like there were some other things. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Here's one. And I believe I heard this on Fox 25 this morning. About the guy who went out and started his car to warm up and went back in his house. And when he came back out, he had a ticket on his windshield for his car running unattended. Yeah. You know, a lot of people tell me that we live in a safer world now than we did when I was a kid. But if you can get a ticket for having your car running, and there's, it wasn't a ticket for pollution, or it wasn't a ticket for idling noise, like a lot of times you hear around truck stops and stuff. This was a ticket for just letting your car run without being in it. And I guess the cops said, well, you know, the ticket is a lot cheaper than what it would cost you if your car was stolen. You know, but if we live in a safer world than what we did back then, it doesn't make any sense. And here's another point. How many times in the summertime have you gone through a construction zone, seen a police car running on the side of the road with the AC on and the hood propped open and the cop nowhere out directing traffic somewhere? They leave cop cars running all the time. Yeah. When I was driving truck, we used to leave the truck running most of the time, especially in the cold weather. And when we got out of the truck, we leave it running and lock the doors. So you can do that. What about remote starters? If you remotely start your car on the way out to the car, can you get a ticket in the time it takes you to walk from your house to your car? Because your car was running and nobody was in it? Again, rules made up by people that have no common sense. I don't know. It's just dumb. All right, we've got 8 minutes left. Or thereabouts. I think I heard somebody come into the studio too. But I haven't seen anybody come to the window yet. Let me go. I found a news site. I Googled in funny news headlines from 2016. And I got this site called pleatedjeans.com. And there's some 24 funny news headlines. And some of these are banners across a screen, so you can't actually see the picture, but like the lower thirds on a news show. One of them is from Fox 2, wherever that is. And the headline is, homeless man steals EMS rig to go to strip club. It says one way to get there. And be prepared just in case anything more comes of the visit. This is an Action News story, badcriminals.com. Got a picture of a McDonald's and this big fat guy, and it says, man trades baby for 15 Big Macs. It's the baby burger trade is we've got Florida rapper gets pulled over and hands the officer his mixtape instead of his ID. The Coventry Telegraph, I almost want to say that's British. One of their headlines was racist swan attacks students. That's an old one. Looks like it came from CNN. It says breaking news, more sad news from the music industry. Kanye West is found alive in his apartment. Here's one from The Real Story. Pug starts fight with police dog during 4-hour standoff. That's kind of funny. Koala escapes at zoo, falls asleep before he can do anything interesting. And if this is real, it's pretty cool. London celebrates the Monty Python reunion by putting a 50-foot dead parrot in Potter's Field Park. He's not dead. Breaking news, and I can't tell. It's a picture off of a TV screen that says moments ago, and it almost looks like it might be MSNBC or CNBC or one of those. It says breaking news, President Obama, I'm going to get something to eat. Disgusted Central Park mugger rejects victim's flip phone. So that's, you know, one tip. When you're out, maybe have a crap phone. You know, just for when you're out and about and you maybe going into a bad neighborhood, you don't want to take your iPhone in. Get yourself a cheap flip phone. Most robbers hate them. Missing woman. Where was this from? Doesn't even say. Missing woman unwittingly joined search party looking for herself. Chinese zoo under fire for disguising hairy dog as a lion. SWAT team heroically ends 6-hour standoff with empty apartment. It was the Dallas-Fort Worth area SWAT forces. Just last year, they kept America safe by raiding an organic farm and taking their tomato plants. Mugged by a parrot, thieving bird grabs Scots tourists' 700 lira wad. I don't know. Those are kind of dumb. But that's what I had for some funny news headlines. I didn't go and get any stupid facts this week because, I don't know. Like I said, it's been busy. By the time I get home, I'm already too sleepy to watch any news and try and figure out what's going on. Confirmations are coming up, I guess, for the cabinet post. You know, it's been fairly quiet, I think, on the political arena at right now anyway. The Dems are still hating. What can we say? Maybe that's it. Maybe that's just the way they are. And I don't know. It's just not much. And it's Tuesday and it's been a long week already. And it's getting longer. We've got City Council starting back up this week. Wednesday and Thursday committee meetings. Next week City Council. And like I said, the school budget stuff is going on. What else is going on? Keep your eyes open. Some brand new shows is going to be starting on Cheshire TV this month, including Ask Cheshire TV, a show where you, the viewer, will be able to email questions in. And if you have any questions, email them to askctv at CheshireTV.org, and we'll get those answered for you. It's a show that's being hosted by Mark Nelson, one of the Cinemaniacs and executive director here at Cheshire TV. He's going to be interviewing show producers. You may see video tips, how to make better video. Who knows what you'll see? You'll see a lot of great information and have any questions that you have answered on air. And that's what we're here for. Anyway, my time's running down there. I'm not going to take it right down to the last second this time. We'll have some room for a little filler here at the end. So if you watch on Facebook, hit the share button and share me. And if you watch on YouTube, there's a subscribe button right down there somewhere. Hit the subscribe button and you'll get every episode of everything I post. So until next week, I'm Rick Blood. This is Unfiltered. Peace.